Hi there. Well, this is my second follow-up video to my little drawing video, the first one I did, and we did a little, just a little drawing of a robin, and this was my reference that we used. And I thought what we could do today is just have a little bit of fun and use some pencil crayons and do a little colouring in drawing of robin. So I think that'll be a bit of fun because I haven't coloured in anything for a long time, and I've got all these pencil crayons and pencil colouring pencils lying around, had them forever. And so we're just going to have a bit of fun doing a little pencil crayon drawing from the same reference that I did the drawing from. So yes, my name is Janice Lazzarich and I'm a member of the Iron Shed Creatives. We've got our studios up in the old school, so we're in lockdown at the moment, so we're working out of home. And so I'm looking forward to doing this, and let's get going. Right, so as I said, we're going to use this photograph of a robin to do our little colouring in with pencils. And I'll just talk you through what we're using. I'm using these Stabilo Carb Othello pencils because they have quite a nice pigment in them, and they're actually aquarelle pencils as well, so you can mix water with them. And also, I just wanted to say while I'm right here that the best way to sharpen these is with a craft knife, because I tried sharpening with a normal sharpener and the leads are so strong, so well pigmented, that they're very soft and they just seem to crumble every time I used a normal sharpener. So I recommend a craft knife for them. You can also get sets like these, which are Staedtler aquarelles. Also water. Also you can use water with them. But if you don't have any of those, you've got also got all these lovely pencils that you can buy for children these days. You can just use an ordinary colour pencils. You can even use wax crayons if you like. That might be quite fun. I might try that too. And what else? We need a pencil with a 2H lead in it. So that's quite a hard lead. And the other thing I thought I might try was these Derwent water brush. Things which look like this, and it's got water in the back here, and you've got like a brush on the top, and the water goes through here. So I might try using these once I've put some of the pencil down. I've actually not used them before, so that's going to be new for me as well. So what I want to do first is take a very heavy graphite pencil, like a 4B, a 6B, an 8B, and if you remember in the first video I did I took a little tracing of the bird that I'd drawn, because you've now laboriously drawn this bird out, and I wanted to keep a tracing so I could use it for the colouring in and for the oil painting. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put this picture down here. I'm going to turn it over like that, and then I'm going to rub graphite onto the back. And then we can just trace our drawing down and we can start colouring in. Because I don't really see the point of spending a lot of time drawing it out again when I've already just done that. So this is just a good way of saving a bit of time. And you've drawn it yourself anyway, so it's not like you tracing it off something else, which is obviously something you can do as well. There's no rules in art, you can do exactly what you like. Nobody has to follow the rules in art. It's all about playing art. And it should be fun, and it should be about playing. As soon as art becomes stressful, then it becomes a bit of a nightmare. Drop. Pencil on the floor. Right. So I'm just use masking tape, any old masking tape you can get. I think this is probably comes from a paint store. And I use it for putting onto skirting before they paint walls. So, what else do I want to say here? This paper, I'm using a different paper to the one that I used for the drawing. The drawing piece of paper had quite a lot of texture to it. Whereas this is a piece of Bristol paper that I'm using, but you can use... Bristol paper is this sort of paper board. It's a beautiful board paper, 220 gram. It's a beautiful paper to work from, but not everybody might have that at home. So you can use ordinary cartridge paper or any paper from a sketchbook, any normal sketchbooks like this would be good. And this sketchbook's got quite a lot of grain on it, so it depends whatever you like. If you like a grainy drawing, then you can use something with a bit of a tooth, a bit of a grain. But I want to just try this. Well, actually, I had this pad of Bristol paper for a long time, and I've not used that either. So we all end up with loads and loads of art equipment everywhere in our cupboards that we don't always use. So we have put some graphite on the back, and we've stuck it on top of our paper. Cartridge paper or a board, and then we're using this is a 2H lead in here. It's quite a hard lead, so you don't want to use your soft leads, because they're not hard enough to withstand this, and you'll end up sharpening them every 2 minutes. So let's just get this in. Have a look underneath and see. Oh yeah, it's coming out. Remember that highlight on the top of the eye. A very rough line here about where the orange stops and the other colours start. Actually everything else on there. If you can hear voices in the background, that's Dave on the conference call. So we can't drown that out. And I'm not putting music on the back of my videos because I listened to something last night, someone who was doing a drawing. And he had music going on and he was trying to speak as well, and you couldn't hear what he was saying because of the music, and I just think that's really distracting. So I'm sorry if this is very quiet, but I prefer that. I cannot have a lot of noise and distraction going on when I'm trying to paint and draw. At the end of the day, painting and drawing is a bit like a meditation, and it should be something where you're going into yourself and most of the time when I'm painting I can't even speak, so it's quite difficult doing a demo. You're trying to get in the zone of painting and then you've got to speak as well. So anyway, so there we go. What have I left out anything? Got that leg in, got the other leg in. We've got more little feet in. Right, so that's what that tracing was for. So you could just trace that down quickly. I'm going to use the same tracing to trace down onto my canvas, and then do in my next video, and then I'm going to do the little oil painting of it. But that's for another day. So get going with this. rid of that. So we've got our little drawing. And obviously if you haven't got a tracing, you can draw this out again the way we did it in the first video. I'm going to do one or two other drawing techniques as well, but I just want to take this little project to do the follow-up in the colour and to do the painting, and then I'll get back into the drawing, the other drawing technique, which is also useful. So here we go. What are we going to do first? This is our reference. So I was just want to show you how to sharpen one of these leads. And as I said, if you use sharpener or any of these sort of things, it just breaks lead off. So maybe the sharpener would work for these sort of normal pencils, but because these ones have quite a lot of pigment in them, they're so soft. So I'm just going to show you quickly how to do this. When you're actually taking some of the wood off, be very careful you don't cut into the lead, and then just use very short little movements like this with your knife to actually pare it down to a point. You can see, right. There we go, just get rid of that. And we're going to start doing our little drawing. My camera went off when I had started this already, so I'm just going to start this again. What have I got here? This is the black. And we'll do the eye first. And the beak. These are nice and dark, aren't they? Let's swap to try and get these browns. Same thing as when we did in the drawing with the pencil, just try and do little strokes to indicate feathers, and do these strokes in the direction that the feathers grow. This could do with a bit of a sharpening blunt. Anyway. If you keep changing the direction of the way you put your marks down, it already gives an impression of different feathers. I think what you should do is just keep changing colours when you see any colours like light, just get a grey. That looks like a nice sort of burnt umbery grey. Have we got greys here? This is quite a light grey, isn't it? Might have to use the black one. Anyway, let's put some of this. It looks lighter than it is. And once again, as I said in the drawing, start off lighter and then looks a lot lighter than it comes out. Use some of this for the beak. The top of the beak's quite light, it almost reflects the sky, so it's got, seems to have quite a bit of blue on it. I might put some blue in there rather than the grey. I wonder what colour this will come out. Quite nice, probably. You don't have to do it all blue. And maybe we could put some white in there. I wonder what this will look like. Right. Lots of things we can play with here. I think I'm going to put a bit of orange in here now. Start a bit of orange. Might start with the lighter colours first. Seems to have little feathers going around the eye. In and out in a direction that goes up. Excuse me. Sorry if my head gets in the way, I forget. this light colouring. Down there, let's get a dark red. Not sure if this is the right colour, maybe more of a burnt sienna-y colour. A warm brown colour. Slightly different brown under here. I need sort of cooler brown here. I just want to get this in here. Go over some of that warm brown. Dark orange in here. Right, we're getting down to this little area which is in shade down here. So you could probably introduce one of these sort of burnt sienna sort of colour. Try and keep your strokes sort of loose. You can always tighten up later. You might want some loose, not everything too. So I've got a burnt sienna colour and I've got like a light raw umbery colour, which is a nice cool brown. Use them for some of your little shadow colours. Some of this orange on top. Some lighter orange, almost like a yellow in here. If you want the pigment to come out quite sort of intense, then go over it a bit. Some areas will have quite loose strokes and others you can lay it on quite thick, so maybe the same principles can apply as in oil painting, where you do your dark colours first and then you put your lights on top. And where the lighter colours are, if you make them, scrub them on so they're nice and intense. Where the dark colours are, you could maybe make them more sketchy. Just an idea I had while I'm doing this. I have no idea whether that will work, but I'm going to try it. Right, let's do a little bit of the silver. Just in case you're wondering, this is my set of colours that I'm using here. I don't know if you can see them all, but quite a nice box. I've had it for a long time, so it's really nice using it. Who would have known it would take lockdown to get all these things out and start using them again? I'm looking for grey. Is this light grey? Let's put some of this grey colour in here. Actually quite a warm grey this. You can also do this a little bit faster than what I'm doing. I'm just taking it slow and doing it slowly because it's really the first time that I'm doing this too. You can see by doing the like little set of strokes in different directions, it already gives an impression of a feather. So I might change colour. Black seems to be quite dark, but maybe it will do the job. It's just coming down the center of the belly there. Anyway, you can. I might speed through the rest of this. And then at the other end, you can see how we've got on. I'm going to change to the browns in the wing here now. This is some really light. But here. So what browns have we got? We've got these, one, one. Which ones should we use? Maybe this is like that. This one down the back here. Even though it's really light there, just try and put it on in like little V shapes. It's like an indication of feathers. Now the wing. There's a big kind of shadow in the centre here. Well, what colour are we using here? Get these little tail feathers in. What should we have here? Yeah, cool or warm brown? Maybe warm brown? Just put a bit of soft brown in here. And this seems to be like quite a warm little edge to them. Back here with this feathers that are sticking out the back. Leaving loads of little there's pigment all over the page. Okay, let's just put a bit of dark underneath the wing here. Pull this dark up a bit of shadow in here. I might still put some black on those wings just to make them the lines pop out a bit. But I want to introduce some sort of raw sienna colour in here. line this tail, feathers that go into the tail, and actually I think go on the bottom edge. Let's try and get the sort of, I'm just going to leave these colours for a bit. Try and get a little white and grey. And what are these colours underneath here? Almost like an olive green. White. And small. Let's try these colours. I think this is the right colour for the shadow underneath here. Now we also have quite a bit of cool grey in there. And what am I thinking? Maybe introduce a bit, maybe a little bit of olive green in here. And I might put a little bit of blue. It's very blue, this blue-grey. Maybe this colour will work. Let's just try it out and see. And maybe even like an ultramarine blue in these areas at the top. I was just thinking this needs a bit more colour. I quite like that. So I'm just putting a bit of white in here. Experimenting actually, because really I've I I'm also having a play with this, so not really done much with this for an awful long time, but I've now discovered the white, so that might lighten up some of these colours that are a bit dull and just bring them forward, especially on this tail here. White on the edge here, where these feathers are quite white. I might have to clean this edge up with a putty rubber. And I might just try and clean this up a bit. Try and do the feet. What colours do we need for the feet? I mean, they seem to be pinky browny. Pinky brown. Let's get the browns back. And let's start with this dark brown and just try and get some of these darks in. Like we've got all these little marks that go around the feet. They kind of look like a wrinkly kind of, I think they're kind of slightly prehistoric looking. Take this foot right up into the feathers where it's a little shadow down there. Excuse me. Maybe I'll put this up there so I can see it better. Hopefully I'm not obscuring the view. Make sure I put them down. sometimes, I forget. I'm filming. Can't start humming. I think this burnt sienna colour maybe we could use, yeah. Quite a strong colour actually. Quite strong. You're best to do the feet quite carefully, otherwise they just look like a mess. So it's really at the end of the day better not just to rush them, because you can spend quite a lot of time on your drawing and then rush your feet and end up with these funny looking things. And yeah, what a pity. Now I think I might put some white on top, because that seems to create like a quite a nice colour with this burnt sienna underneath. So before I start again, the camera went off while I was doing the sky, and I did rub some of the sky with my fingers, because I think that looked quite nice with that little sort of swirly rubbing out. Some of it looks a bit untidy. I think that looked quite good, but I'm now just going to add a little bit more blue, because I think this is a bit pale here. So you can rub it out with your fingers. And before I carry on, I'm just going to put some black on these claws. Just to try and make them stand out a bit. I think that looks better. Anyway, this blue. I kind of rubbed out some of this. I quite like the way it rubbed it out. But I want to put a little bit more blue in. These definitely said aquarelle pencils, but I wonder if they're actually pastel pencils, pastel crayon. Actually, these are pastel crayon in pencil form for dry mixing or blending, aquarelle, a bowl, highlight process, blah blah blah. I didn't realize these were also kind of pastel pencils. That's why they are blending so well with when you rub them. Interesting. Shows how many times I've used them. Not. Some lines in a different way, see what happens. Different direction, I mean. Not sure I like that. Maybe those are alright. I think the thing about drawing is quite nice to have lines, crisscrossing and things going on. my grey. Well, I think I'm going to leave it at that because I could carry on messing and messing and messing and swiping you and having a little play. I'm going to leave this at this point and invite you all to have a go and show me your drawings. And I'm going to do a little oil painting of this next, and I'm probably a bit more familiar with the paint, so that should hopefully go quite smoothly. But I really enjoyed this. This was fun. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching. Okay. Well, thanks very much for sharing this time with me and watching my video. I enjoyed using these pencil crowns, which I thought were pencil crowns, but they turned out to be pastel aquarelle pencils. So, and that's the big problem, because we've had all these sets of pencils for years hanging around, and you know, our lives are so busy we don't get time to take them down and try them out. So I really enjoyed having a go at them, and I hope you got some sort of tips out of it, or at least would inspire you to do a little bit of colouring in at home. And the next thing I'm going to do is a little oil painting video of the same robin, which is more familiar to me, so that should be great. And thanks very much for watching. Bye bye.